Ron Logan of Delphi, Indiana, born on October 14, 1939, and was looked at early on in the case back in February 2017 as a person of interest but was never considered an official suspect by Indiana State Police. Liberty German and Abigail Williams went missing on the Monon High Bridge Trail on Monday, the 13th of February 2017, and their bodies were eventually found on Tuesday, the 14th of February 2017. Many people thought Ron Logan was possibly the person in the image released to the man on the bridge because he wore a similar jacket and hat in an interview shortly after the girls were considered missing and found deceased. They also thought he was involved because the girls' bodies were found in an area of land which he owned on the Monon High Bridge Trail. Ron Logan passed away on the 24th of January 2022 at age 82 because of health complications from the coronavirus disease COVID-19.
The Murder Sheet, a podcast investigating the unsolved murders of Abby Williams and Libby German, provided us a copy of this search warrant, and it reveals new facts about the crime scene where the girls' bodies were found out back on Ron Logan's Carroll County property on February 14, 2017.
This is the gate they left down.
2 days after the bodies were discovered, Ron Logan showed us around his property that backs up to Deer Creek and sits at the bottom of the gorge where the Monon High Bridge towers up above, where Libby German and Abby Williams met the man who took their lives.
Hey, there's the crime scene down there. See how the ground's much more matted down right in here? I think you're right there.
The search warrant from March 17, 2017, recently made public, reveals Libby German shot 43 seconds of video on her cell phone of this man following them on the bridge at approximately 2:13 p.m. on February 13th. And at noon the next day, the girls' bodies were found on Logan's property. There was quite a loss of blood, and the investigators think the killer may have gotten some of that blood on him. An item of clothing was missing from one of the girls, and quote, it also appeared the girls' bodies were moved and staged, leading investigators to theorize that the killer took a souvenir from the crime scene and maybe took pictures. It looked to investigators like the girls died without putting up a fight. Unknown fibers and hairs were collected from the scene. The search warrant authorized investigators to seize any guns or knives Logan had in his house, take a sample of his blood or bodily fluids, and his cell phone.
This is my backyard. My backyard just happens to be bigger than most people. How many people have a murder committed at their home in their backyard?
The FBI agent who requested this search warrant wrote, quote, I believe there is probable cause to believe that Ronald Logan has committed the crime of murder. The document shows Logan created a false alibi for the time the murders were committed, but he was never charged in the case. Logan was sentenced to 4 years in prison for violating probation in a drunk driving case, and that may be why he lied to investigators. We don't know if the search warrant turned up any evidence specifically related to the Delphi case. Logan died in January. In the newsroom, Russ McQuaid, Fox 59 News.
Russ, thank you. And since that day in 2017, investigators have followed many leads, including a fake social media account the girls had contact with. You can read more about that timeline on Fox59.com right now. Police are still looking for information to find the person responsible for Abby and Libby's death. Here's that tip line again, 765-822-3535. You can find that and the email tip line at Fox59.com.
A petition statement was filed on March 13, 2017 by a Carroll County Superior Court clerk, Andrea A. Miller, for the amendment and revocation of Ron Logan's probation terms. It states that Ron Logan violated the terms of his probation on the morning of the 13th of February 2017 when he drove his vehicle to the Carroll County Transfer Station, thus committing a new criminal offense of driving while suspended. It also states he violated the terms of his probation when he was seen consuming alcoholic beverages at the Pizza King in Americus, Indiana on the 27th of February 2017. On Tuesday, the 17th of May, 2022, the podcast couple The Murder Sheet released the probable cause affidavit of Ron Logan's property where a search warrant was issued and conducted for the date of March the 17th, 2017.
Rogers News at 6 o'clock starts now.
We're finding out that there was things that were said that were not true, or that things that were that we've uncovered since the interviews that we're just double checking to make sure everything's lined up.
That brought police back to the Delphi property where the bodies of Libby German and Abby Williams were discovered. We broke that story today with that push alert that you got around noon. And we want to stress tonight, the homeowner has not been arrested for or charged with the girls' murders.
The homeowner is being held on an unrelated and alleged probation violation. Just hours ago, his attorney reached out to us and told us the landowner had, quote, no involvement in this heinous crime, saying in a statement, quote, I would like to caution the public to avoid jumping to conclusions before law enforcement has completed the ongoing investigation.
Still, as Logan sits in jail tonight, we've got Rich Van Wyk, who's been sitting outside his house as police went through it today with a warrant. Rich?
Scott, this investigation here, search started 6 hours ago. There's no sign of it letting up soon. We have the FBI, state, and local police searching the house, the garage, the outbuildings, the field behind the outbuildings, even into the woods. This is just a few hundred yards away from the girls, from where the girls' bodies were found. Police seized hands full of evidence, hauled away Ron Logan's pickup truck, and searched the home, garage, and farm buildings with the help of a canine. Investigators aren't saying precisely what brought them here or what they're looking for.
We want to either clear him or look at him even harder.
The girls' bodies were found just a few hundred yards away from Logan's home in a secluded wooded area of his property. In the weeks since the murders, the 77-year-old has talked with us often, walked us back into the crime scene.
Largest tragedies in Carroll County history.
He's denied having any connection to the murders of Abby Williams and Libby German.
I was cleared by the authorities ages ago.
But since then, police say they've received leads and other information, leading them to believe the details Logan gave investigators don't add up.
We're finding out that there was things that were said that were not true, or that things that were that we've uncovered since the interviews that we're just double checking to make sure everything's lined up.
Police arrested Logan earlier this week on an unrelated probation violation. He has a history of drunk driving convictions, but no record of more serious or violent crimes. Investigators warn against drawing any conclusions. Since their investigation began 4.5 weeks ago, they've conducted dozens of searches, interviewed scores of potential suspects, and given some of them polygraph tests. They've made no arrests.
We've done all kinds of things to other people, and it's all part of trying to clear them and try to get them to either be more of a suspect or to get them clear out of the picture and get them cleared and so they move on with their lives.
This investigation, this search, though, certainly has people talking. Earlier today, one of the victim's grandfathers drove through here as people were getting set up for the search and blocking the road off. Emily, you've been talking to him. What's he been saying?
Well, Rich, we know from investigators that when the public hears from family members, namely Mike Patty, Libby German's grandfather, the number of tips goes up. They surge. Patty has said it could take only one tip, the right tip, to break this case. So we reached out to Mike Patty today to ask him what he thinks about investigators being back at this property here today. Here's what he had to say, quote, my reaction is, I hope the investigation, wherever it takes police, leads to the arrest of the person or persons involved. Now, investigators say with this latest development, the searching of this property, more tips have come in again today. And a frequent mantra among investigators about solving this case, Rich, has been today is the day. Of course, we had this massive search that's still going on today, but no arrests.
And Emily, I think this is a surprise, and it is extraordinary to be searching an area that is so close to a crime scene that is over 4 weeks old. You'll be following the story tonight. When there's something new, we'll put it online and, of course, on the night beat.
Emily and Rich, thank you.
And if you know anything that could help police solve the murders of Libby and Abby, authorities want to hear from you tonight. You can call the tip line without giving your name. The phone number's on your screen. It's 844-459-5786. We've got this number posted along with the tip email address on WTHR.com and on the WTHR app.
Indiana State Police searched Ron Logan's entire property and checked the detached garage, the outbuildings, and Ron Logan's white Ford F-250. Indiana State Police searched for any possible incriminating evidence pertaining to a murder, such as articles of clothing, fibers, weapons including guns and cutting instruments and any electronic devices used to produce cellular signals detected to law enforcement in the area of a crime scene. They also searched for any animal hair samples which may be linked to the crime. Indiana State Police also checked for any evidence which may have a possible connection to the case, such as computer equipment and any equipment related to the creation of videos or photographs or communication information such as email communication and texts. The metadata, such as the operational gathered metadata and the human-authored metadata from any of the possible equipment and metadata from the videos and photographs which may have been found, could have been valuable evidence to connect Ron to the crime. On February 14, 2017, at approximately 9:20 a.m., Ron Logan contacted Redacted Mail 1 and asked him to tell the police that he came to pick Ron up at Ron's home between 2 and 2:30 p.m. on February 13, 2017. Ron Logan further told Redacted Mail 1 to say that he drove Ron to an aquarium store in Lafayette, Indiana. Ron told Redacted Mail 1 to say they returned home to Ron's house between 5 and 5:30 p.m. Redacted Mail 1 said Ron Logan never asked him to lie about an alibi in the past. On March 5, 2017, during a probation violation search, a receipt from Aquarium World in Lafayette dated February 13, 2017 with a checkout time of 5:21 p.m. was found. At 2 o'clock p.m. February 14, 2017, Indiana State Police along with Carroll County Police conducted a joint press conference stating they had found and recovered two bodies, but they did not confirm if the identities of the bodies were Abigail Williams and Liberty German. Ron Logan asked for a false alibi in the time period of when the girls were murdered on the 13th of February 2017 between 2 p.m. and 2:30 p.m. Redacted Mail 1 also said that Ron did not ask him to lie when he drove to the transfer station earlier on in the day. Why did he ask for a false alibi at 9:20 a.m. on the 14th for the day of February 13th between 2 and 2:30 p.m.? Why that particular time? Was it simply bad timing and a coincidence? Was he elsewhere doing something he wanted to hide? Was he driving to another place or doing something he wasn't supposed to? Was it over agreements to do with his probation over a vehicle on his property? Did he happen to see something from a distance and realize what had happened? Or was he somehow connected to the crime and no evidence was collected in the March 17th search of his property to tie him to the murders? The bodies of Liberty German and Abigail Williams were discovered at approximately 12:17 p.m. on February 14, 2017 on the property owned by Ron Logan. When Ron Logan asked for the false alibi, it was not known if the girls were murdered or at what approximate time they were killed. The cell phone information showed a call placed using Ron Logan's cell phone produced call tower data. The information showed Logan's cell phone appeared to be in or around his property on February 13, 2017 at 2:09 p.m., although his exact location cannot be confirmed. The tower data showed that Logan's cell phone was in the Delphi area in the area of the Monon High Bridge Trail. Ron Logan wanted a false alibi from Redacted Mail 1 for the time between 2 o'clock and 2:30 p.m. on February 13, 2017 to claim Ron was in Lafayette, Indiana buying fish at the time of when the murders took place. An analysis of Logan's cell phone data revealed a text message sent from his phone at 7:56 p.m. on February 13, 2017. The initial exam of this analysis indicates Logan's phone was likely outside of his residence and in the proximity of what Liberty German and Abigail Williams' bodies were located. An analysis of Logan's cell phone data revealed a text message received by his phone at 10:16 p.m. on February 13, 2017. The initial exam of this analysis indicates Logan's phone was likely outside of his residence and in the proximity of where Liberty German and Abigail Williams were located.
A new twist in the hunt for the killer of those two Indiana teenagers. Investigators executed a search warrant at the home of this man, Ron Logan, who owns the property where the bodies of 13-year-old Abigail Williams and Liberty German were found. Cops took away a white Ford pickup truck during the search.
Who is safe here or anywhere else anymore?
Ron Logan is now in custody on an unrelated probation violation. I recently spoke to him about the murders.
You just cannot believe this terrible thing that happened to the community and the families actually happened here on my property in my backyard.
He told me he has an alibi, buying tropical fish 20 miles away.
Yeah, I was not home during the time that all this was happening. I was in Lafayette.
Yeah.
And I didn't get home till approximately 6:30 in the evening, and then the neighbor stopped to ask for permission to look back here for the girls.
Liberty German shot this chilling image of the suspected killer approaching the girls on a hiking trail, and she recorded the killer's voice.
What do you hear on there?
Nothing that I recognize at all. No one. I don't recognize the voice at all.
I asked Ron Logan to repeat those same chilling words.
Down the hill.
And that image of the suspect?
The picture is of such poor quality, it doesn't look like anyone I've ever seen.
Police have not revealed what led them to search his home, but said in a statement, "We basically are here to try to eliminate him or put him as a higher suspect in our case." Ron Logan told me he is devastated by the discovery of the bodies on his property.
That was like being hit with a bolt of lightning on my property. You just can't put words to it.
A lot of people believe the voice on the video recording from Liberty German's cell phone was a match to Ron Logan's voice. An audio forensic expert tried to compare James Brian Chadwell's voice to the voice from Liberty German's video recording, and he said the audio is too short to make a proper comparison.
Steven, basically, the audio file is a little too short. When you only have 3 seconds, it's just not enough time to figure out those kinds of characteristics.
When I look at the short clip of Bridge Guy in the middle frames, I see a man with a mustache and a goatee with wider face who might seem older, and in the later frames I see a younger man with a narrower face and a longer nose. I see a person with a navy jacket over a hoodie with a brown shirt tail poking out wearing a brown baseball cap with a curved bill. I initially remember the original video shown was not the same one they released later on, where Bridge Guy appeared slimmer and taller. Although, I think they simply stretched out the image and messed with the aspect ratio and resolution after altering the video quality in an attempt to improve it more. I'm not sure the physical characteristics would change that much, but I do not know how the video was edited and altered. I heard it was altered from an angle so people could see the person walking from the bridge. I also believe Bridge Guy was 65 feet away when Liberty German recorded him. The video is obviously of poor quality, and anomalies are in the video, such as video artifacts and overall distortion of the pixels, along with motion blur causing somewhat of an illusory effect on what we're actually looking at. I can see why at first glance many think it is Ron Logan due to the jacket and hat he is wearing. In some frames, Bridge Guy appears to have a mustache, and some people believe the hat Bridge Guy is wearing is a match to the one Ron Logan was seen wearing shortly after the murders occurred. I'm not sure you can categorically tell if the hat Bridge Guy is wearing was the same as the one Ron Logan was seen in shortly after the murders occurred, with the green circular emblem on the front and the white square on the left side of his hat. The navy jacket Ron wore had the logo, Indiana Kitchen, on the left side chest area of the jacket in yellow. In my opinion, I believe Bridge Guy is shorter and with a smaller build than Ron Logan. Although, it's hard to make a proper comparison due to the overall poor quality of the video and the distance he was filmed at whilst also looking down at the bridge. I also don't think the killer, if assumed to be Bridge Guy, would wear the same exact jacket so soon after the murders, considering it would have potentially lots of blood from the victims if he did not take the jacket off prior to the attack. In the probable cause affidavit, two females were mentioned who had intimate relationships with Ron. They described his behavior and talked about how threatening and violent he could become. On March 8, 2017, redacted female 1, was interviewed by law enforcement officials. Redacted female 1 met Logan about 7 or 8 years ago. Redacted female 1 was in a personal relationship with Logan for a couple of months and would stay with him in his home on the weekend. Redacted female 1 left Logan after he became physically abusive. During her interview, redacted female 1 explained that Logan continued to stalk and harass redacted female 1 after their breakup. During the relationship, Logan had dragged Redacted Female 1. Out of her car by her hair. Redacted Female 1. Still fears Logan. Redacted Female 1. Has not had contact with Logan in approximately 2 years. Redacted Female 1. Told interviewers that Logan had told her in the past that he could kill her and no one would find her body. During her March 8, 2017 interview, Redacted Female 1. Said that she knew Logan carried a gun everywhere he went. Redacted Female 1. Knew that Logan would carry a gun in a fanny pack. Redacted Female 1. Described Logan's fanny pack as one made out of a nicer material. During her March 8, 2017 interview, Redacted Female 1. Told law enforcement officials when she first saw the photograph of the man on the bridge, she thought the police were looking for Logan because she thought the photograph was Logan. Redacted Female 1. Did not initially realize that the photograph was that of the suspect. On March 14, 2017, Logan's former housemate, Redacted Female 2, was interviewed. Redacted Female 2. Resided with Logan from about September 2016 through December of 2016. Redacted Female 2. Was in a sexual relationship with Logan on off for approximately 3 years. During the interview with law enforcement officials, Redacted Female 2 said when she first learned that Abigail Williams and Liberty German were missing and then found dead near Logan's home, her initial thought was that Logan was involved. Redacted Female 2 said in her interview that she feared Logan and even previously told her baby's father if she ever ended up dead, Logan did it. On March 14, 2017, Redacted Female 2 explained in her interview that Logan had been violent with her in the past. Redacted Female 2 explained that on July 4, 2016, while at Logan's home, Logan punched her in the face, knocking her down. Redacted Female 2 explained that she was drinking, but Logan was completely sober during the incident. Redacted Female 2 also explained that Logan was angry because she disrespected Logan and Logan's home. After reading the two female accounts of Ron, I think he may have a short fuse. An anger problem. He perhaps keeps control of the majority of the time in public but may unleash his anger when things don't go his way in a private setting. I've heard negative rumors about Ron in the past, but murdering two children is a huge leap from domestic abuse. It's given me pause for thought that possibly there was more to Ron Logan than meets the eye. It was mentioned in the affidavit that an article of clothing of one of the victims was missing from the crime scene while the rest of their clothing was recovered. Nicole Robertson also stated that it appeared the girls' bodies were moved and staged. She states based upon her training and experience, it is common for perpetrators of this type of crime to take a souvenir or in some fashion memorialize the crime scene, whether by photos or electronic or digital methods. I think if you were looking at this from a serial killer angle, it might make sense that the killer took the article of clothing as a souvenir to memorize the event and to hold on to for sentimental value. The Collector was a book where the main character Frederick Clegg took a lock of hair from a woman he abducted to store away in his collection. The book has inspired serial killers and abductors such as Christopher Wilder, Robert Burdella, Leonard Lake, and Charles Ng. The simpler reason as to why it could have also been took is because the killer's DNA was on that article of clothing. It's also stated Liberty German and Abigail Williams didn't have visible signs of a struggle or fight, and during the processing of the crime scene, investigators location unknown fibers and unidentified hairs, which may later be used for comparison of similar fibers or hairs. The affidavit also mentions the last contact with Liberty German and Abigail Williams by cellular device at approximately 2:13 p.m. and the GPS latitude and longitude coordinates at the time. It's speculated that maybe the bodies were moved from that area and staged at the crime scene location where the bodies were found. Barbara McDonald asked Keegan Klein in his prison interview in 2021 if his father or if he knew Ron Logan, the landowner who owned the land where the girls were found. Keegan said he didn't know who Ron Logan was. Ron Logan had let many people on his land over the years that it's possible he came into contact with Tony Klein, given he's an avid hunter. There's also now speculation that a video of the murder exists because of Garrett Kurtz's interview and the new information surrounding the Kleins involving child sex abuse material. Murder has been video recorded in the past, but I'm not sure if a snuff film as in a person paying for it to happen to gain pleasure from watching ever existed. I imagine on the dark web there's a possibility of something awful like that being real. Toby Leasenby stated that Ron Logan was covered and said that simply to protect any information which might change in an ongoing investigation if Ron Logan happened to become a suspect and was brought to court for the double homicide. Ron Logan's defense attorney could argue he had been cleared of the murders previously if the word cleared was used instead of covered. I read from other sources online that Logan was cleared. A police officer tweeted that Logan had been cleared and it was mentioned in a couple of news articles about the case. Ron Logan was never considered a suspect, only a person of interest in the investigation. He was sentenced to 3.5 years in prison on the 10th of April 2017 for violating the terms of his driving probation. He was eventually released after serving roughly under 2 years of his sentence. Is Ron Logan bridge guy? I don't know. I think the video is of too poor quality to give a proper comparison. Bridge guy was also filmed at a relatively far distance, which may make him appear differently than he would closer to the camera. I think Ron Logan is taller than the person walking across the bridge, but I don't know what process law enforcement went through to edit and alter the video. I think they altered the video from an angle so the public could view the suspect. The only information I found odd is Ron Logan asking redacted mail one for a false alibi on the 14th of February 2017 at 9:20 a.m. for the time period between 2 and 2:30 p.m. around the time the girls were murdered. The time may have simply been a coincidence. He may have lied not to be looked at for his probation violation. Ron Logan's property was searched in March once for guns and then for any possible evidence which could connect him to the crime scene. I think he may have had enough time to hide the murder weapon and destroy any incriminating evidence if he was involved. Although, I think a trail of scientific evidence may have connected him on his comings and goings to his property. The probable cause affidavit was worded very well to make a strong statement that they think Ron Logan may have done this. It's been 5 years since the murders and the initial release of Ron Logan's probable cause affidavit. Ultimately, it's old information and Ron Logan doesn't strike me as someone who really planned out the murders considering it was on his backyard. Although, you could say he knew the land better than the majority of people and would know where the best place is on the land to commit murder. There's still also a possibility that the murders are not connected to the Kleins and the Anthony Schatz account. I think that's unlikely considering the Kleins tried to create false alibis via social media and Indiana State Police are asking for more information in regards to the Anthony Schatz profile. Ron Logan passed away at the start of 2022 and he may have taken some secrets to the grave.